Right, you lot, and an opinion that absolutely infuriates me is when people say that music is just not good anymore. That people who have absolute refused to admit that anything of the past 15 years has any credibility or worth to it. I mean, it just frustrates me. And well, the past 10 years is filled with so many mediocre and acts just bombarded onto your face looking at you, Iggy Azalea. For the commercialisation and the crap that is bombarded onto your faces on the radio 24/7, there are some genuine gems that are truly era-defining that people just tend to overlook. We'll just say the 80s is the peak of music and we will never relive that without realising that music has actually come a long way and there's a lot more, you know, actual access to music now. In the 80s, you were forced to listen to the same three bands over and over again. Now there's a whole world of variety out there. I feel like people fail to actually realise that. Now, 2022 for me was an inconsistent year for music. There wasn't really a distinct theme or style. However, I do actually appreciate that over summer, like 2017, where every American pop star made a run-of-the-mill Spanish track to capitalise on Despacito. Demi Lovato, why did you do that? Oh. Right, and before all you lot start crying and complaining, the criteria of the list is if I'm only including songs that reach the UK top 40, so that does rule out Broadburn, tragically. So if your favourite indie group or your bloody hipsters out there, while your favourite bloody band or whatever wasn't on it, that song is probably better than some of the hits of the year, but I've probably not heard it, and even if I had, I couldn't include it. So please don't get your knickers in a twist. Also, I want to preface this by saying that you are going to disagree with me on this list. That is almost guaranteed. My musical taste is very biased. I'm going to be honest. I tend to kind of lean more into songs that I can emotionally resonate and connect to. I tend to really get behind songs that mean something to me. And for me, music is very spiritual and very much can tamper my mood like a bullet, which is why in the past I've actually had a lot of hesitance to state any musical opinion beyond the classic Queen good, Bieber bad, like surface level stuff, because, you know, it means a lot to me, music, and, you know, I have a very weird taste, and you are gonna laugh at some of my picks, but please, can you not get over the top over this? We're not 5 years old, we have our own opinion. I'm doing this list as a bit of a passion project, that's my sole reason for doing it, and I just want you to enjoy it. So anyway, enough meandering, let's get on with the list. And the 10th best pop song of 2022 is Becky Hill's Remember. I can already hear you typing. Hear me out. Becky Hill is quite remarkable, considering she's genuinely the only contestant from The Voice to have any success. I'm not joking. Bloody hell, that says a lot about The Voice, doesn't it? Even pop idol, Will Young at least. Anyway, many will say that Becky Hill is kind of just does the same song over and over again. And I can't disagree. However, I feel like in a year of misery, Becky Hill's upbeat tunes are quite a joy. I think that's probably why this has landed on this list. The song is lyrically strong, as she talks about the struggle of thinking you're over someone, only to be unable to escape the constant reminders. I feel like that's something that most people have kind of struggled, including myself. Becky is so vibrant and paints the picture well, but she keeps it vague as well to protect the partner, something that someone like Olivia Rodrigo could really learn from. Overall, it's really just a jam and really just a fun, upbeat song. It's not Grammy worthy, but I just enjoy it. I think it's a good vibe, and I think that's all you need sometimes, you know? That's what a lot of the 80s songs were, come on. And the 9th best pop song of 2023 was... hopefully you can get behind this one more. It's Dermot Kennedy's Dreamer. This is such a raw and powerful ballad. I'm an absolute sucker for ballads, as you may know based off my music. I love a ballad that just paints flaws in a personal self and is just honest and open, and Dermot does this so well. I'm kind of a sucker for Dermot's voice. I mean, it's just so unique. And for all like the auto-tune and half-assed rap tunes about girls, money and drugs, Dermot just has this unique authenticity, and it's so great, and it is in sort of similar vein to early Ed Sheeran. He's not sort of chasing hits, he's making what means something to him. You feel the desperation in voice, as he really needs this woman, and it really leaves goosebumps in the audience. Everything about this song is just so gorgeous, and for me was the standout of the already great, strong album from Dermot. And the 8th best pop song of 2022. Okay, going into this, I knew I'd pick a Youngblood song. Everything about Youngblood is just great. It's just great, from his charisma, to his originality, to stage presence, to the absolute balls to just be whoever you like. He really is an icon, it's just incredible. This man is just one of the best around. So it was really tough to just pick one. But I went for his song, Don't Feel Like Feeling Sad Today. A great anthem about the damage of social media, and why hiding from it makes your mental health superior. The instrumental in the song is so strong and just makes the track an absolute vibe. The song's really short but actually quite effective, and I love playing it first thing in the morning. Like, just gets you going. It's so atmospheric, and you feel like the positive escapism was just so good in a year like 2022. Ah, and it's only 8th. Now on to 7th, and the 7th best pop song of 2022. Okay. Oh, this one's gonna be unpopular. I put Heatwaves. This was for certainly the surprise hit of the year, as an indie band blew up. It's just so catchy and sort of genius, but also like horrendous. It's so unique. The chorus is one of the best of the year, and I think sometimes simplicity can really make a banger, and I think Heatwaves is a great example of that. I'm so glad that something so different and distinct did so well. It's a song that really gets you on your feet. This song is just so good in the background, and it just has this sort of soothingness to it. I don't know, there's something about Heatwaves that's just really touching. It's sort of a miracle it's this good, Heatwaves. I can't believe, like, it's this high. And the 6th best pop song of 2022. Let's be honest, you knew it was coming. Taylor Swift's Anti-Hero. Bloody. It's safe to say that Taylor Swift has been a mixed bag of output throughout the past 10 years. That's for sure. She's definitely had her missteps. Still, I can't stand Look What You Made Me Do or Bad Blood. And I feel like any time she tries to make a political standpoint, it falls flat. When it comes to her hitting, or when she tries to hit back at haters, she flops for me. She's best when she focuses more small scale and more intimate on sort of herself. It feels better. She's definitely had her critics. However, I feel like in this decade, she's made the correct steps and mood. I thought her Red album was great in 2020. And I think the way she handled that lawsuit she had was just so inspiring. How she re-recorded all her tracks just so it was hers was such an incredible success story. And as for her new album, Midnight, it's truly delivered and put Taylor on track again. And for me, the lead single, Anti-Hero, was a standout. And after releasing song after song after song after song after song, degrading X after X, she turns around and said, maybe I could be wrong. Am I the problem? In such an earnest attempt at honesty. I just think it's such a good jam, and I think for her to have that kind of realism and authenticity is just so good. I think I have to address one line here, and that is, of course, the sexy baby line. And for anyone who kind of mocks this line, you're actually misinterpreting a genius metaphor, comparing yourself and the damages of that, and, you know, social media. It's so clever, but people just say, I get this thing when I think of a sexy baby, and people just rain on it. I love all of the imagery and metaphorically stuff she does here, and honestly, it's truly incredible. And the 5th best pop song of 2022 is, oh boy, brace yourself, I put a Little Mix song. I put Between Us. 2022 was a year to forget for the band, as they finally crumbled after a decade. I mean, Little Mix had a good run, but Jesse Nelson's controversies, and then them called the band out. The band took a break, but they sure went out on an absolute high. With Between Us, a single that feels so thematic as we go back to what made these girls shine first and foremost, the chemistry and commitment, which couldn't be more evident here. The harmonies are just unreal and powerful and show the bond that these girls have had. And even as someone who doesn't particularly care for the group, it got me truly invested. I adore all of the musical callbacks in this one. I feel like that's always just a clever thing when artists do that. Going back all the way to the beginning is just such a spectacle. And even for a non-Little Mix fan can get behind this. So if this it was the end of Little Mix, it was a truly worthy send-off. Another ballad though, Birdie L. And the fourth best pop song is with breakout star Lauren Spencer Smith. I actually adore this girl. Her voice, her authenticity, she is going to be big. And her big single Flowers, not to be confused with that meh new Miley Cyrus song, was so incredible. As Lauren sings in retrospect about a guy who completely let her down despite all the beliefs she had in him, and is now so relieved that she has a better partner. Lauren's such a good storyteller, and you can tell just by her delivery this genuinely affected her, and did happen. As I've already said about three times, I'm an absolute sucker for ballads, and everything about this is just stripped and raw and just absolutely gorgeous, and it capitulates in such a powerful song. I used this song's instrumental for a demo of my song Bandage, and this style really helped me kind of on my journey, so I feel like I have a lot to thank this song. Overall, such a truly authentic track and is really a must hear. Breaking into the top three with the third best pop song 2022. Jesus, how do you get better than that? We have a powerful one with Dean Lewis's How Do I Say Goodbye. This is such a touching tribute over to his late father, as he now sings in just disbelief and losing the person who gave him his name, as he draws on the burden to carry on without a male figure in his life. The song, in similar vein to Flowers, is just so raw. The instrumentation starts quiet and really helps place the emotion of the track. This track really just is a proper tearjerker and so relatable. I feel like loss is something we all face in our life, and I feel like there's some topics that you can write about that is just so vivid and real for anybody. And I think the way Dean Lewis kind of portrays this song, it's you can get behind it. And I think I always enjoy songs that lead it vague, because you can kind of put yourself in there, and even if you've not been through it, you can recollect sort of similar situations and really involve, and I think that's so powerful. And the second best pop song of 2022 is one you could probably never guess. I've gone for Pale Wave, Reason to Live. I needed this song at a point in my life. And while maybe not as deep as Flowers or How Do We Say Goodbye, for me, as the lead singer sings about love keeping away from suicide. I love any song that are just oxymorons, where the subject matter is sad but the instrumentation is upbeat. I feel like it just makes it more powerful and even more heartbreaking for me. This song is just such a jam and serves as great real escapism. I feel like it takes back to kind of a pop rock vibes, and I feel like it kind of really stands out amongst other things in the charts, if anything. Lyrically, it's just genius. And I really love the vagueness here again, and you can really insert yourself into the song. For me, the relatability massively increases the enjoyment. I love any song that does kind of a slowdown of the chorus before bellowing the chorus out, and this song just does that excellently. This is just a perfect song for me. And it was really a surprise, as I hadn't really been introduced to Pale Wave prior to this, and I think when they kind of introduced me, I really got into it and absolutely adored what they did. But this song really kept me going at parts in the ear when I really needed it, and I think if I didn't have this song, I don't know what I would have done. Maybe you won't feel the same way about this song, and maybe this is kind of a personal thing for me, but for me, it's the number two. And there's still one more better. Right, now before we get to number one, a couple of honourable mentions. Bloody hell, I really feel like Watch Mojo now. Firstly, I guess you could say 15th, I've gone for Minnie Webb's House on Fire. Such a great anthem for a breakout star. I just appreciate the vibe. However, I feel like more just stand out for me, and it's quite similar to Remember, which I got behind more. 14th, I've gone for another Youngblood track. I love to. Literally the only reason I didn't include this is because I already had a Youngblood track. I love this. It's a song that correctly uses auto-tune, and I feel like any song that actually correctly uses it, I dig, and I really like it. I also just love any song that calls out homophobes. It's just brilliant, isn't it? 13, I had to throw something Disney on here, and I have thrown on Surface Pressure, which for me was the best song in Encanto. I mean, I know we don't talk about Bruno was the big one, but for me, Surface Pressure was the more clever one lyrically. The vocal is just so strong. The underlying message of, like, you know, burdens, and even, you know, a lot of Disney films are about magic and stuff, and, like, you can't really relate to a lot of it, but Surface Pressure was a song that I feel like people having to rely on responsibility and being overworked is something that I feel like a lot of working class people do kind of go through. 13, I've also thrown on, 12, I've thrown KSI's Not Over Yet. It's just such a catchy, atmospheric and mood-setting song. So catchy, I love the background vocals, but I only didn't put it on the list because, like, it's a YouTuber, mate, and, like, yeah. I can't be seen doing that, can I? 11th, I also threw Lauren Spencer Smith again with Fingers Crossed. I kind of wanted to only have one song per artist on here. That's the only reason I put Fingers Crossed here. This was the predecessor to Flowers, and although slightly weaker, this chorus absolutely slaps for me. It's just incredible. And the number one pop song of 2022 is Lewis Capaldi's Forget Me. I rate this man so bloody much. He isn't exactly a Prince Charming, is he, if you look at him? And if you told me this man becomes a star, I would have laughed in your face. But honestly, vocally, he is just off the charts. This song was such a step off of something like Someone You Love, which had pretty basic instrumentation and really was just a run-of-the-mill ballad on every level. I'm just glad, you know, that he's really appeased critics who, you know, fans loved him, but critically, he didn't get the greatest reception. I feel like he really played into that with his bloody album title. In this song, he talks about an ex who moved on and forgot him, as a vulnerable Lewis pleads that the hard times are worth it, with the incredible line, "I'd rather hear how much you regret me than forget me." He's just vocally off the charts. His power and passion is so evident, and the hook is so strong. It really is just a masterpiece on every level. I can't think of a more deserving person. The guy is brilliant. Like, if you ever watch him in interviews, he's just so funny. My top spot is also... This song also really helped for me, which it just completely mirrored a situation I went through in 2022, so no bias there. Overall, he's deserving of this title. Congratulations, Lewis Capaldi. And there we are! I've done what I set out to do. I've proven that today's chart does have some credibility. You just have to, you know, get through a lot of crap. You know what, I probably won't do a worse list, because it kind of defeats the objective, so kind of do me a favour and don't ask. But anyway, that was the top 10 best hit songs in 2023. And you know what, I really enjoyed doing this. If you want to see more kind of music lists or similar stuff, because of course I'm going to be doing the film analysis stuff, release my own music, vlogs with the boys, but I kind of wanted to do this as a kind of experimental thing. It was an idea I had from way back, and I thought, you know what, I need to finally do a video revealing my music taste, and I feel like this is a kind of a big milestone for me, so yeah. Next week, I'm going to be doing the Kenobi video, I believe. So yeah, we got that coming up, so I hope you enjoy. Goodbye, you lot.